Welcome to the presentation of our paper titled Simple Pair Pose, Pairwise Human Pose Estimation in Dense Urban Traffic Scenes. It has been a joint work of the Intelligent Vehicles Group at TU Delft and the Environment Perception Department at Mercedes-Benz. We present a new method for human pose estimation, which is an important task for fully automated driving applications. There, it may be used as intermediate representation for different perception tasks, like the hand gesture recognition of bicyclists, shown here on the left. This recognition helps predicting lane switches of bicyclists. There's also a recent work by Videro presented last year, where pose estimation is used for recognition of traffic control gestures of police officers. Pose information can also be used as additional explicit feature for trajectory prediction and intention estimation of pedestrians. A reliable performance is crucial, as errors in the estimated pose might also result in errors of the overall intention estimation. This also holds for crowded scenes. You may imagine a group of persons waiting at the border of the street. Every single person might step on the street, even a highly occluded pedestrian in the back. So every person should be detected, including a precise pose information. We focus on exactly that challenging scenario of crowded scenes with highly overlapping pedestrians. There are mainly two approaches for human pose estimation, bottom-up and top-down. Bottom-up approaches, like the open pose method shown here on the right, first detect our joints within an image and then cluster these into instances. Open pose here use a graph-based matching for this clustering. Top-down approaches first detect all objects within an image, for example using a bounding box-based detector, and then estimate the pose for each object by taking an image crop. We follow this top-down approach as these methods are still leading on current benchmarks like MS COCO. Of course, this approach depends on the performance of the underlying detector. A missed detection will also result in a missing pose information. We are particularly interested in crowded scenes, where we often end up with missed detections. So we not only focus on an improved pose performance in crowds, but also on an improved detection. So, how do we end up with missing detections in groups? When we look at the raw detection output of common proposal-based detection methods like YOLO, SD, or faster RCNN, we see that there are multiple detections per object. This happens as we usually have more proposed than objects, and each proposed box is classified independently. Therefore, these methods depend on a so-called non-maximum suppression to end up with exactly one detection per object. Usually, a surprisingly simple greedy implementation is used that only relies on a single intersection of a union threshold for suppression. No appearance information is used, so this algorithm cannot really be aware of the number of objects present. In this example, it works out pretty well. But if you look at a denser scene with higher overlaps between pedestrians, there are missing detections. There is also another issue with these methods. The proposals are usually only associated with a single crowd sample. Hereby, the target object might be ambiguous. That is shown with the simple toy example of the set detection work down here. The fork and the knife share nearly identical bounding box, so it's rather unclear which one should be detected based on a proposal. They solve this ambiguity issue by predicting the full set of present objects for each proposal. Technically, this is done in the network architecture by duplicating the prediction head. Thus, multiple boxes with multiple class scores are predicted for each proposal. Boxes predicted based on a single proposal do not suppress each other, solving the issue of missing detections in groups. We build up on this work in our approach to improve the detection performance. Interestingly, there's also an ambiguity issue in top-down pose estimation, as an image crop might contain several persons. In that case, the target pose might become ambiguous. InPose solves this issue by adding an additional instance queue as input to the network to select the target pedestrian. They use a bottom-up method to retrieve this instance hint, which costs additional runtime and the instance queues themselves might be error-prone. We compare our approach to AlphaPose Plus, which is also a specialized method for pose estimation in crowds. They first estimate all joints for each detected object and then run a graph-based optimization in a post-processing step to reassign joint points. OcPose is a very recent method that depends on pose from AlphaPose Plus's input. It uses a graph convolutional neural network to optimize these poses, which also happens jointly for pairs of pedestrians. We guess that by improving pose performance in comparison with AlphaPose Plus, OcPose could also profit from our method. For the development and evaluation of a new method, you depend on appropriate datasets. We focus on dense urban traffic scenes in an automotive setup where the availability of pose datasets is limited. Regarding detection, we have released a very diverse dataset 2 years ago, the EuroCity Persons Detection Dataset, that we have collected in 31 cities of 12 different countries. So far, we mainly provided very precise bounding box, orientation information and other attributes for more than 200,000 persons on 47,000 images. For this work, we have extended this dataset and created the EuroCity Persons Dense Pose dataset as major contribution. For the original ECP dataset, we only used images from the front-facing camera. For our new pose dataset, we also selected images from the side-facing cameras. For the selection of the images for manual bounding box and pose annotation, we focused on scenes with a high number of persons. For the original images from the ECP dataset, that was done based on the number of bounding box annotations. For the new images, we have run a faster scene detection method to find images with a high number of persons. We end up with 47,000 images, of which only 14,000 are part of the original ECP dataset. We have the highest average number of poses and the highest number of pose annotations among the automotive pose datasets. The Tsinghua Daimler pose dataset is a very recent one. In fact, it is also published in the context of this conference. When we look at the density of the pedestrians, which is defined as the highest intersection of a union with any neighboring pedestrian, we get this distribution here on the right. We do not show pedestrians here that do not overlap at all. We are interested in cases where the density is greater 0.5, as the non-maximum suppression is often configured with this threshold. This results in missing detections, in particular for higher densities. We see that 5.9% of the pedestrians have a density greater 0.5, but only 0.2% have two neighbors with an intersection of a union greater 0.5. Therefore, we focus on pedestrian pairs. These pairs are defined as two pedestrians with a mutual intersection of a union greater 0.5. Riders are not as frequent in our dataset as pedestrians, and also these pairwise situations are not that often. Therefore, we mainly focus on pedestrians. Our method consists of two parts, the pairwise detection and the pairwise pose estimation. Let's look at the pairwise detection first. We extend the EuroV3 detector by the set detection idea presented in the related work section. This detector usually only has a single prediction head connected to different feature layers of a darknet 53 network. This head has two laws for classification and localization. We duplicate this prediction head. In contrast to the set detection work, we solve the ambiguity issues explicitly by defining beforehand that this upper head is responsible for predicting pedestrians in the front and the lower to detect pedestrians in the back. This ordering is defined based on the lower bounding box edge, making use of a flat world assumption. In this example here, we end up with a green front box and a red back box for these two pedestrians, as this front and back predictions do not suppress each other in the pair NMS. With a usual greedy NMS, one box would have been removed. For the pairwise pose estimation, we take an image crop of the combined box of the pedestrian pair. In our network, we build up on the same network as used in alpha pose. There, a pose set consisting of two upsampling modules and a convolutional layer is connected to a ResNet core network. We duplicate this full pose set and solve the ambiguity issue by once again defining the upper pose set to be responsible for the pedestrian in the front and the lower for the pedestrian in the back. Doing so, we do not depend on an additional instance queue as hint pose and also do not need a post processing step as alpha pose to optimize pose, as we estimate both poses jointly in a single step. For non-pair pedestrians, we only use the front prediction head in the pose part as well as the detection part. For evaluation on our new dataset, we begin with the detection experiments. We compare different variants. The base model is the plain EuroV3 method trained on our dataset, while the pair model makes use of the second prediction head. We evaluate a special variant where we simply discard the back predictions. We use the log average miss rate, as in the original ECP detection benchmark, to compare the overall detection performance. The performance for the pair model, even without the additional back predictions, is slightly lower due to the additional prediction head. In the right columns, we evaluate the recall for test samples that have an intersection of a union greater 0.5 with another pedestrian evaluated for two false positive per image rates, 0.1 on the left and 1 on the right column. The back predictions increase the recall. This can also be seen in the detailed figure on the right for densities above 0.5. We used the detections of the pair model as input for alpha pose plus and our network for pairwise pose estimation. We used the same training settings for alpha pose and ours. The only changes are that we have the second pose set, we combine box before cropping and do not depend on the crop-based post-processing of alpha pose. Here, we compare qualitative results for pedestrian pairs for alpha pose plus on the left and our approach on the right. So let's zoom in a little bit. Front detection and pose are green, while we use red for the back pedestrian. The performance for the front pedestrians is pretty similar. But alpha pose sometimes fails to find the joints of the back pedestrian and confuses poses of the back with the front pedestrian. By training our approach to jointly predicting both poses, it's pretty consistent in guessing a separate pose for the back pedestrian. It has some errors in particular for the often occluded legs of the back pedestrian. Quantitatively, we used the object keyframe similarity to measure localization accuracy of the estimated poses and show the mean OKS on the correct lit detected pairs for our simple pair pose method and alpha pose plus. The median is shown in brackets. For OKS width, we only take visible joints into account, while OKS all considers even the occluded ones. As indicated by the qualitative analysis, there's only a small improvement for poses of front pedestrians by our method here in the first two columns. Regarding poses of back pedestrians in the last two columns, we outperform alpha pose, in particular when we only look at the OKS for visible joints in the third column. We also calculate the overall pose performance using the log average miss rate as in the original ECP publication by using the OKS for matching instead of the intersection over union. We evaluate this metric on different subsets for up to 40 and up to 80% occlusion and for different matching thresholds of 0.5 and 0.75. We also evaluate different scores for the pose predictions, the original box score and a score taking the pose confidence from the heatmaps into account. We see that our approach is also slightly better than alpha pose plus. A higher difference can hardly be expected as the relative amount of these pairwise situations is rather low and alpha pose plus and our method makes use of the same detections as input. The rider performance here serves as baseline performance on our new benchmark. We do not apply pairwise training for riders as rider pairs are pretty rare, therefore no performance difference is expected here in the lower rows. We have presented our new simple pair pose method that combines pairwise detection and pairwise pose estimation. The pairwise detection adopted from the set detection idea improves the recall in groups, which is crucial for the follow-up pose estimation. We make use of pair detections to jointly estimate poses of front and back pedestrians, which improves the pose performance for these very challenging occlusion situations. Our pose network is very efficient, as apart from the duplicated layers, all computations are shared. In the future, it would be interesting to integrate our approach into other methods and use it with other detection methods optimized for dense urban seeds. It would also be interesting to use our pose approach in combination with the graph convolutional network of OCPOS to see if the overall pose performance can be further improved. Finally, our new EuroCity Persons Dense Pose dataset will be available on our website and hopefully will lead to further advances in this exciting field.